We'll begin the opening statement with Vivian Moreno.
Are we ready?
Yes.
Good evening. Should I use it?
Yes.
Good evening. My name is, can you hear me?
Yes, hello.
No. Okay, stop my time.
Good evening. My name is Vivian Moreno. And, you know, I wonder all the time, how did I get here? I am a skincare girl. How did a skincare girl get from being a skincare girl to a candidate for mayor? Well, I'm going to tell you. When I was a skincare girl, I had a problem with the city of Riverside. And I wanted to fix that problem. And I realized I could not fix the problem. So I decided I was going to go and I was going to figure out why I could not fix that problem. And I did. And I dug deep into the city documents, and what I found, I was shocked. I found waste, fraud, and abuse. And I found that our staff and elected officials were having a party. They were having a party on all of us. They were having $6,000 parties. They were traveling all over the world. They were staying at the Four Seasons Hotel. We bought every cup of coffee our city manager purchased. We also bought breakfast, lunch, and dinner regularly for pretty much all the management staff. For 6 years, I took this information to the council and the mayor, and they ignored me. They called me crazy. They called her the Fab Five. They called us critics, and now we're perennial critics. When a citizen is trying to find the truth about what is going on in our city, they ridicule us. Today, we have a new city manager, Mr. John Russo. John Russo stated in the Press Enterprise that we are facing a financial reckoning of magnitude proportion, and that the general fund needs propping up by other funds. And the only tools available is to cut services. The city has used public utilities as our cash cow. Thank you very much.
Next, we'll hear from Nancy Melendez.
Thank you, Judith. And thank you, Latino Network and NAACP Riverside, the group, and the League of Women Voters for your efforts to inform voters on the issues before us at the ballot box this year. A special thanks this evening to the League of Women Voters, who remind us of the hard work it was for women to gain the right to vote. It was a 50-year-long battle that finally ended with the passage of the 19th Amendment in 1920, giving women in the United States the right to vote. A right that was denied to them in 1776 by culture and customs. But I applaud the League for its efforts in honoring the work of Susan B. Anthony, Elizabeth Cady Stanton, and Lucy Stone. I certainly would not be here before you this evening as a mayoral candidate were it not for these pioneering women. But indeed, I am here before you tonight, and I am a candidate for the mayor of Riverside. You know, women comprise 50% of our population, yet I don't see that reflected in our elected officials on the dais at City Hall. I am here to offer you a choice. A choice to increase that 0% to a beginning 12% representation as your elected mayor. For too long, too few have been indeed invited or encouraged to participate. Our city government should reflect our community not only in composition, but in its willingness to accept change for the greater good through increased collaboration. I will bring over 40 years of experience in community collaboration through my volunteer experiences with numerous nonprofits and my service on boards and commissions serving Riverside families. This experience has given me opportunities to team with people from different cultures, backgrounds, income levels, and perspectives. Together, as a team, we work to find common ground and come up with solutions for the common good. The position of mayor is one of influence, not necessarily power. The mayor's office should be a conduit of information and communication flowing from the council to the public and from the public to the council. Our city charter states that the mayor shall advise the council of the will of the people and shall interpret the council policy to the people. This communication should be collegial with give and take on both sides.
Thank you, Nancy. Next, we have Rusty Bailey.
Well, it doesn't get much better than being the mayor of your hometown.
I was born and raised here and have a lifetime commitment to Riverside. My legacy of service begins with my grandfather as a teacher at RCC, and then my father as a judge in our Superior Courts. My educational pursuits took me to West Point and the Army as a helicopter pilot, to UCLA and then to DC to serve the federal government, to Cal State San Bernardino to earn a teacher credential. I chose to come home to bring my knowledge, skills, abilities, and gifts to bear toward Riverside's future and to raise my family here and to continue that legacy of service started back in 1914. I loved working and teaching government and social science at my alma mater and shaping the future leaders of Riverside. And I continue to do that through school visits, lectures, and direct mentoring. I was proud to serve in the City Council for 5 years as we built for the future of Riverside through the Renaissance. That public investment has returned twice that $1.6 billion invested by you, the taxpayers, from 2008 to 2013. More than $3 billion has been invested by the private sector and through economic growth at our universities and college. Proof that we are better together in Riverside. Now let me share with you some of our successes over the last few years. Some awards. Top 10 city for women-owned businesses. Number 1 U.S. city for small business by Inc. Magazine, 2014. Number 2 hotspot for tech in the U.S. by Forbes. Coolest California city by the California Air Resources Board, which is moving to Riverside. Number 3 in economic and job growth in the state. Number 2 millennial boomtown in the country. Playful City USA designation nationally for 8 years in a row. Number 9 in the U.S. for solar power generation. I believe everything rises and falls on leadership, and that Riverside is rising because of leadership throughout our city. Leadership in the business sector, in our universities and colleges, in our faith-based institutions and nonprofits, in our neighborhoods and schools, and in our new leadership team back at City Hall. And as your mayor, I remain committed to the philosophy of servant leadership, to listen first, to represent, to problem solve, and to make decisions through consensus building and collaboration, all toward doing what's best for Riverside's long-term prosperous future and for generations of Riversiders to come.